Welcome to Tales of Honor Podcast, a podcast dedicated to telling the true stories of every recipient of the Medal of Honor. Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Tales of Honor Podcast. I'm your host, Christoph Ambrosch, and this is episode number 315. We're going to go back to the Vietnam War, as per usual, for this month and all of last month, but I have two birthdays to get into before we get to that. The first is actually for today, and this is another Vietnam recipient. Retired Colonel Gordon Roberts turns 70 today. His birthday is the 14th of June, 1950, so very happy 70th to Gordon Roberts. And tomorrow's birthday is for Jose Rudela. He is also a Vietnam War recipient, and he is turning 83 years old tomorrow. He is a retired master sergeant. So a very happy birthday to Gordon Roberts today and Jose Rudela tomorrow. That's all I got for birthdays today. Let's move right on in to episode number 315. Lewis was born in Brooklyn, New York on the 19th of June, 1945, and after graduating from Archbishop Molloy High School in Queens, he attended SUNY Maritime College at Fort Schuyler. He withdrew from college and went to work as a lineman for a telephone company before being drafted for the U.S. Army in 1966. He was deployed to the Republic of Vietnam with Company C, 1st Battalion, 12th Infantry Regiment, 4th Infantry Division, and it was his actions on the 15th of February, 1967, that would earn him the Medal of Honor. The citation reads, "For conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity at the risk of his life above and beyond the call of duty, PFC Ouellette distinguished himself while serving as a rifleman in Company C during combat operations. His squad was conducting a security sweep when it made contact with a large enemy force. The squad was immediately engaged with a heavy volume of automatic weapons fire and pinned to the ground. Despite the deadly fusillade, PFC Ouellette rose to his feet, firing rapid bursts from his weapon, and moved to a position from which he placed highly effective fire on the enemy. His action allowed the remainder of his squad to begin to withdraw from the superior enemy force toward the company perimeter. PFC Ouellette covered the squad's withdrawal, but his position drew heavy enemy machine gun fire, and he received multiple wounds, enabling the enemy again to pin down the remainder of the squad. PFC Ouellette struggled to an upright position, and disregarding his painful wounds, he again engaged the enemy with his rifle to allow his squad to continue its movement and to evacuate several of his comrades who were by now wounded. Moving from position to position, he engaged the enemy at close range until he was mortally wounded. By his unselfish acts of bravery, PFC Ouellette ensured the withdrawal of his comrades to the company position, saving their lives at the cost of his life. PFC Ouellette's valorous actions were in keeping with the highest traditions of the U.S. Army and reflect great credit upon himself and the armed forces of his country." Lewis Edward Ouellette was 21 years old when he died, and he is buried in St. John Cemetery in Middle Village, New York, Section 037, Row M, Plot 024. His name appears on panel 15E, line 37, of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Wall in Washington, D.C. And that was a Tale of Honor. Thank you for listening to Tales of Honor Podcast. Head on over to talesofhonorpodcast.com where you can read these stories, see other ways to support the show, and easily share a story with your friends and family. Tales of Honor Podcast is written and produced by Christoph Ambrosch, and theme song, A New Beginning, is by Ben Sound. If you have any questions or comments, you can send them to talesofhonorpodcast@gmail.com. And until next time, I'm Christoph Ambrosch. Thanks for listening.